All right. So for those of you who do not know me, I am Erica Webster, the owner of Dub Fitness. Dub stands for the W in my last name, in case you were wondering. We will not be doing any dubstep music tonight, but I do want to thank Camp Pressure District for taking the initiative and doing this Move Monday and getting us going inside of our houses, especially on days when we really don't feel like it. But the sun came out, and I think that that's a really good sign. Today's workout is broken up into four different sections. Each time we move into a different section is when I will demonstrate the movement for you so that you are never left to guess what the movement is. The way that I run the class is you take your break and your water break when I'm demonstrating the next movement. So use that time wisely. I will also not say go drink water. So if you are thirsty at any point or feel like you're going to need a break, just take the break. Totally okay. I left my Army uniform at home, so I'll not be yelling or screaming at any of you, just motivating you. The King of Pressure District actually set up a really cool tip jar, which is something new that I started hearing about through this whole quarantine thing. So it's really awesome to be able to support each other. And you can go to their Facebook for that, and also go to their Facebook to learn more about Dub Fitness and what we do here. We are actually an all-women's gym located in King of Prussia, and it's all based on empowering you and meeting you where you are. Now, the structure of today is going to be the warm-up, the conditioning. We have two finishers. One is for your abs, and one is for your arms. You are going to need the chair for the middle portion, so something sturdy. I have a folding chair over there. And then you're gonna need a hand towel or something that you are able to grip with both hands. So definitely not washcloth size and definitely not pull oversized towel size. It's gonna be a little difficult. If you don't have those items, a pillow will work. And then for our arm finisher, we use 2 to 3 pound dumbbells. Canned goods work, something a little bit heavier than tomato paste, but not as heavy as maybe a can of beans per se. All right, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna do a warm up together. It is timed, it's about 3 minutes long. I walk you through each movement for 30 seconds. And then after the warm up, I'm gonna walk us into the first section. And then we will get into the core and start to sweat. Feel free at any time to pop in, just hit your space bar, ask me a question, take breaks when you need to, and just do your best. All right, we're gonna start our warm up. In 3, 2, and let's go. All right, the first thing we're gonna do is 30 seconds. They're called Frankenstein kicks. So we're alternating our legs and we're kicking them straight up. So add a little energy behind it, throw your arms around, but the goal is to touch your foot with the opposite hand. Swing up those legs, good. So remember, everything we do in our warm-up is for 30 seconds, and the idea is to kind of tell your brain, hey, send some blood to my extremities, to my muscles. They need some loving. I'm about to work them out. All right, we're gonna switch to what's called ankle grabs. You are gonna grab a hold of your ankle, not your shoe, and you're going to pull up. Ankle, pull it up, okay? The idea, again, is to stretch out those hip extensors and those hip flexors. So pull up, grab a hold of that ankle. Remember, you don't want to grab your shoe. You don't want to twist your ankle, pull up on that joint. Grab a hold of your ankle, pull up. You need to find somewhere on the wall to brace your hand. That's okay too. It is just the warm up. You do you. You have about 6 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, next movement, squat, toe grab, in that order. You squat down, you grab a hold of your toe, you straighten out your legs the best that you can, and you rise straight up, okay? So we squat down, grab a hold of our toes, lift our butts up, and stand up. Your hamstrings should start to warm up. Good. Force that stretch on them. Squat. Butt is up. Stand it up. One more, okay? Squat. Butt comes up. And rise up. Good. All right, we're going to drop. to all fours, hands and knees. We're gonna do shoulder rolls to the front. You're rolling your shoulders up towards your ear, forward. So don't move your whole body. I know it feels a little awkward, but just roll them forward as if you were standing doing it. Good. All the way up high, roll those shoulders. And now you're going to reverse it. So just take the shoulders and roll the opposite way. Make sure your hands are underneath your shoulders. And just relax with it, okay? Roll it back. And then next, you're gonna take your hands and you're gonna put them under ever so gently. You're gonna sink your butt back to your heels and you're gonna feel that nice little stretch in those wrists, okay? So we're doing planks and push-ups. Sometimes our wrists tend to get a little sore. This is a really good loosener for those. We've got three more. Drop it back, good. We'll do one more. Nice little sink back, nice and easy. You're not putting too much pressure on it. Come back down onto all fours. We're going to alternate fire hydrants. So we're gonna open up on one side, bring that knee down, open up on the other side. Be sure that when you're opening up, you're not tilting your whole body over, okay? Try to keep those hips pointed straight to the ground. Imagine that your two hip bones are headlights and that you need to keep those headlights on the road. Up, and bring it down. Remember, this is your warm-up, okay? It shouldn't be strenuous, it shouldn't be killing you right now, so take your time. Good, got four more seconds. Three, two, one. All right, we're gonna roll over onto our backs for some hip thrusters. Pull your heels to your butt as close as you can. Your arms are straight up in the air. You drive your heels down and you push those hips up towards the ceiling and then you lower slowly, okay? So your belly button drives up towards the ceiling, you're squeezing your glutes, you're digging your heels into the ground, and then you're coming down. Really try to open up those hips, get high up onto those shoulders if you can. We have about 10 seconds. Squeeze. You can rotate those hips on your way down if you want to get them a little loose. We'll do one more. Bring it up. And down, good, all right. For 30 seconds, we're all gonna pretend like we're jumping rope, and then we're gonna drop down to the floor for 30 seconds of mountain climbers. Here we go, three, two, and one. So swinging that rope, and you're leaving the floor, you are hopping as if you needed to give that rope some room to go under. Come on, you're already 10 seconds in, it's only 30. Good. 10 seconds. And then we drop down to the floor for some mountain climbers in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Onto all fours. Your hands are positioned directly underneath your shoulders. You pull your knees in, like high knees of the floor, as I call them. Butt space out of the air. Pull it up. Again, 30 seconds. Take your time, modified, you can just step. You need to slow it down. Otherwise, pump and pull up, come on. 12 seconds. You got this. It's only a warm up. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right.
That was your warm up. No pull up, no 400 meter run today.
All right, grab your water.
Have your water handy.
So that you don't have to leave the room to go get it. All right, round grouping one. It's called 30-20-10. We're doing a focused, bigger movement for 30 seconds. For 20 seconds, we're doing some type of calisthenic. 10 seconds, you rest. We repeat. So we repeat each thing, each little grouping, twice. When I go to demonstrate and explain the next grouping, which again, same idea, that's when you're going to take your break, okay? So the first one we have is a burpee with a hop forward and then a hop back into the burpee.
And we keep doing that for 30 seconds. At the 20 seconds, for 20 seconds, we're doing what are called push jacks. And it's pushing the air like up ahead, like you're raising the roof, okay? So it looks like this. And you're just pushing away from you. And then we rest for 10. The burpee hop forward looks like this. You jump your legs out, you jump your legs in, and instead of jumping your hands straight up in the air, you hop forward and you hop back. Right back into it. Forward, back. Okay? 30 seconds of that. 20 seconds of push jacks, 10 seconds of rest, time 2. Okay? And then we'll rest when we get to the next section. Alrighty. 30 seconds. In 3, 2, 1. Burpee hop forward. Then you come down. Up. Hop forward, hop back. Come on. Jump forward, jump back. You don't even clear like 50 feet, but maybe like 2 to 3 feet. Jump forward and back. If it helps to give yourself a target, put something on the floor that you have to jump over. Come on, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Push jacks, 20 seconds. Good job, good job. I told you that we were gonna get that heart rate up, but I do promise you will get rich. Come on, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest, rest. Water. All right, go again. Burpee hop forward. In 3, in 2, go. Down. Jump those legs up, forward and back. For modified, put your hands down on the ground. Step your legs back. Drop down. Bring your body up. Step it in. Hop forward, hop back. Or step forward and step back. But do some work, okay? Get a little energy. Let that heart rate come up. Come on, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it up. Right into push jacks. Come on. Push. That ceiling away. This is only 20 seconds. And guess what? You're 10 in. Come on, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Woo! Look at that. That's part one. You have 6 total. You just knocked out 1. All right, next one. We have bear plank step backs. And then we have front jacks. So a front jack is when you are going to bring your hands to the front. So we're opening and closing. Like you're opening up curtains and closing them. For the bear plank, you get down onto all fours, knees are directly behind your wrist. You pop up just enough that you have like an inch below your knees. You step back and then we come in, but we don't kneel again. You're alternating your legs, pulling them in, okay? So bear plank step backs and front jacks. Here we go. In 8 seconds, 30 seconds, 20 seconds, 10 seconds, twice. In 3, 2, let's go. That bear plank, step back, bring it in. Alternate the leg that leads each time. Come on, stay low. Keep that butt out of the air. Pull your belly button up in towards your spine. Go, you have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Front jacks, open and close. Keep your hands flat. Meet your thumbs in the middle. Your toes come all the way in as well. Come on. You got it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Because I can see some of you, I have a big projection screen over here. If I'm calling 3, 2, 1, letting you know when the session's almost over, at that 3 is not when you drop to your knees. At 1 is when you drop to your knees. Let's go. Down.
Pop it up, back, and alternate. Come on, core locked and loaded. You're not twisting. Your hands are not out in front of you. Not like Superman. Come on, underneath those shoulders. Stay low. Keep those knees down, but not on the floor. Come on, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. Front jacks, and then get a nice break when I demonstrate the next set. Come on, open, close, open, close. Let's go. Stay on the balls of your feet. You got this, let's go, come on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Water. All right. Round two, done. Here we go. The next one, we have what are called pike pops. Again, you're gonna be in that front leaning rest position, with that plank position. Hands are underneath your shoulders. We're not out here in front like this. You're going to spread your feet to a wide plank. And what you're doing is you're piking up and back. So you pop it up into a little pike and then back into that high plank, okay? And then we have push jacks for 20. It's the first movement we did where we push up and come back down, okay? All right, here we go. Round three. Plank pops in 8 seconds. Remember, you're in that plank position. Feet are wide. You plank them up onto your toes, butt comes up. Go. Plank it up. Bring it back. Plank it up. Bring it back. When you plank it up, I want you pulling that belly button into your spine. Come on. Your quads are also lifting and lowering you. When you go back into that plank position, do not put all of that pressure on your spine. Give your back a break, literally. Time. All right, push jacks. Come on. 20 seconds, 10 second break in sight. Let's go. Woo, I'm with you, come on. Heart rate is up, I'm warm. Woo, thankful we get to do this. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds. Grab some water. Back down to this pike pops. In 3, 2, here we go. Right? Pike it up. Push it back. Catch yourself in that tight plank at the bottom. Come on. Pike it up. Push it back. The same as you are in your house. again. Woo! That's it. Yes. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 second rest. Good job. All right, here we go. 5 seconds, bear crawls. Up and back. 3, 2, let's go. Keep your butt nice and low. Stay down. Let your quads do the work. Come on, butts down. Walk it back. You're more than halfway for your final round. Let's go. Butt out of the air. 3, 2, and 1. Front jacks, come on. That's 20. Go. Come on. Woo! That's it, everyone. 10 seconds. Come on. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Big break. Not really. 25 seconds. All right. Next one. Inchworm walkout into an elbow plank. You push your hands back up, you walk yourself back up to a standing position. Your heart rate should actually come down a little bit for this. You're not running out into that plank. It's slow, controlled. And then we have push jacks. All right, so the walkout. The idea is to keep your legs as straight as possible. So you hinge forward, you walk your hands out, drop down to your elbows. You push back up. Walk your hands back in, open your hips up at the top. What you're not doing is walking on your fingertips. So make sure that your hands stay flat on the floor so that we don't put 100 plus pounds of body weight onto your fingers and they snap. Flat hands all the way. All right, let's go. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, let's go. Hinging forward, walking out. Drop to your elbows. Press back up. Lock it in. Keep your chin lifted or you will get lightheaded. Keep that head up. Drop to those elbows. Remember what I said. You are not racing through this. Tight. Control. Walk out. Legs are tight. Core is tighter. Come on. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Push jacks. Go. Push that ceiling away. Come on. No slack. Let's go. You came here for a reason. I am not going to waste your time. Come on. Push through. 10, 9, 8. Let's go. I'm with you. 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 second rest. Towel off. If you need to use a towel in the workout, I know you have one there. Come on. All right, final set in 3, 2, let's go. Hinge at those hips. Walk those hands out. Be in that good high plank before you decide to grab into your elbow plank. You want to make sure your body is nice and secure so that you don't want to fall into your face. Slow it down, walk it back. And come on up, let's go. More than halfway, you have 11 seconds to go. Drop down softly on those elbows. Core tight when you push up. 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, push jacks. Guess what, ladies and gentlemen? We really only have one more left. One more. Then we move into part 2. Come on. Woo! Sweat burning my contacts. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Find your breath. The trick too, deeper breaths in and deeper exhales will help calm your heart rate. All right. Final movement. These are called pendulum lunges. I say the best for last. The first 20, we're going to do with your right hand. Right hand, your right leg. Your second, we're gonna do with your left. What this looks like, hands are on your hips. You step forward, you swing right to the rear. There's no stop in the middle. You just swing right to the rear. So from the side, you are lunging and you swing your leg forward. Big steps forward and big steps back. Again, make sure you have some space. It is only your right side that we are starting with. And then we have front jacks. And then we do 20 seconds on our left. Front jacks. Then you get a nice long 1 minute break. All right? The pendulum lunges. Key is not to stop in the middle. All right. 3, 2, 1. Right leg. Lunge forward. Swing it right to the rear. Lose that wobble. Hands on your hips if you need to. But they're not on your thigh. Come on. Swing it. If you need to modify, you can tap your foot in the middle. But again, challenge your body. That's where the magic happens. You keep doing what your body already knows how to do. No change happens. Come on. It's those last 3 seconds. You want to talk yourself out of it. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Front jacks. Come on. We don't stop. There's a big break in sight. Open and close. Come on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds. Opposite side. Again. Slow, controlled. Lose the waffle when you go down. In 3, in 2, and 1. Pendulum swing it. Come on. Use that momentum of pushing off of the floor to swing your body forward and backward. Do not smash your knee into the floor, okay? Lightly tap it, see that it exists, and then rise up. Come on. Swing it out, almost there. 8 seconds. Come on, swing. Let's go. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Last 20 seconds. Front jacks. Yes, you can. I'm with you. I know. Come on. Woo. I can see you all. Looking good. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job. All right. Water. Towel off. Grab your chair or your stool or your ottoman, whatever it is that you are using. All right, so the next section is called an EMOM, which stands for every minute on the minute. You are basically in competition with yourself within this minute. So at zero, when I say start, you are going to do 10 tricep dips, 5 knee tucks, and then 2 push-ups, all which involve the chair. When you have completed those reps, those rounds, you then wait for me to yell go again, and then you go back and repeat it. So 5 minutes means 5 rounds. Do not keep going. So after your second push-up, take that time to have a break in that minute. Okay, so for dips, you have your chair. You're going to put your hands, fingers facing forward. You can bend your knees, or you can straighten your legs, which is a little bit more difficult. If you're here, you're dropping down and pressing up. You need to drop all the way down, those elbows go to the rear, and then fully extend your arms at the top. What a dip is not, is this. Commonly mistaken, because your arms are fatigued and tired, okay? That elbow has to bend. 10 of those you're counting. Then you get to sit down in that chair. Hold on to the bottom of it if you need to for balance, or you can keep your hands on the outside. You extend and you tuck in, but your legs need to fully extend out and your back extends as far into that chair as you can. 5. Then you're going to turn over. You place your hands on that chair, and it's 2 push-ups. Chest must touch whatever the object is that you are using, okay? If you need modified push-ups, you drop your knees to the floor, your chest comes to the chair, all right? Whew. Yes. 5 minutes on the clock. You wait for my go every single time, all right? 5 minutes, dips are up first. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1. 10 dips. Remember, all the way down, all the way up. Drive it. Try not to use your feet. All body weight. It does not need to be fast. You do not need to look like a piston moving up and down, okay? Focus. Control. You have a whole minute. When you're doing those crunches, make sure you're pulling in. Extend out. It's 5. Tuck. Extend. Come on. Woo! Remember those push-ups. Your chest needs to touch. All the way down to the chair. 2 push-ups. 1, 2. Good. 15 seconds until I yell go again. Remember, use that time for a break. Those dips, it is not a hip thrust. Make sure you drop those elbows. Here we go, 3, 2, let's go. 10, come on. I'm with you, triceps are burning. These are one of the quickest muscles to fatigue, all right? So then you get to sit down in the chair for 5 tucks. Out, in, come on, cool. 3, you got it, let's go, 2, 1. Make sure on those push-ups you are dropping that chest all the way down or you're dropping to your knees, okay? Good, chest all the way down, come up. Woo. You have 20 seconds until your next round. We're at minute 40. You look good. Keep it up, you have 10 seconds on the clock until I yell go again. Remember, you have that whole minute. So if you know that you're doing really well with those push-ups, maybe slow it down and focus more on those dips. Good, stop, 10 dips, come on. Woo. I know, arms are tired. Everyone is slowing down, that's okay. That's what's supposed to happen, right? That's like what I said earlier. That's where the magic happens. When you're doing those crunches, you really need to use your core. If it feels a little too easy for you, stop holding onto the chair and let your body kind of balance itself. 2 push-ups. Make sure your feet are together, your chest comes down. Keep that chin up, okay? With push-ups, you lead with your chest, not with your hips. Good. 14 seconds. What can work? All right, 5 seconds. Second to last set. And 3, 2, here we go. Come on, give it up. Remember, elbows back. You're not hip thrusting, okay? Bring your feet in if you need a little bit more assistance. Let's go, come on, down and back. All right, those triceps are what give you that beautiful shape in your arm. Right in the back, they give you that nice contour. Come on, send those legs out. You can take your arms off the bottom of that chair if you want more. And remember, when you get to the push-ups, your chest leads, not your hips. Chest comes down and presses up. Your chest touches that chair. 12 seconds until your final round. 5, 4, 3, 2, come on together, we finished this. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Put your foot on that chair. Meet me on those abs. Tucks. 2, pull in. Come on. Pull in like you're getting ready to do a cannonball on the diving board. And you know that push-ups. Make these last two look like something good. Come on. Press to chair. Bring it down. Press it up. And you can get that chair out of your way. Whew. Water. Water, water, water. All right. Moving on to our final big section. Once we get through this section, it's an ab finisher and then a little arm finisher. So we've all heard of Tabata. I have my variation, which we call Dabata, okay? And that's what we're about to do with our towels. We're gonna spend 20 seconds doing a movement, 10 second break, 20 seconds doing the movement, 10 second break, repeat. Very similar to the first round, except we have shortened the time and we're gonna be slamming towels. All right, so again, I will demonstrate one section at a time. First section. Now, you can hold the towel long ways or you can fold it in half. I like folding it in half. I feel like I get way more of aggression out of it, okay? So you're gonna meet me in a side plank. On your left side, two ways you can do this. On your elbow, or you can be up on your hand. I prefer my elbow. Make sure when you're looking down at your body that you are not in a V shape, okay? That you are straight out. Your feet can be stacked or they can be staggered. Stacked is a little bit more difficult. Staggered gives you more of a base. Make sure your elbow is directly underneath your shoulder and we keep our hips up. So we do 20 seconds on our right. Then you're gonna roll over or just switch sides. 20 seconds on your left, and then we repeat, okay? Simple, easy, peasy. Here we go. Feet stacked. In 3, 2, 1, you're up, and you are slamming that towel on the floor with every thing that you have. Your hips are standing up. You are not sagging. You are not falling. Come on. Other side. Let's go. It's fast. You're in control. This is the best thing for aggression. Here we go. 4, 3, 2, pop it up. Opposite side. You get your non-dominant side. You might feel a little weird, but take your time and slam it in. Let's go. Come on. 20. And what that looks like is this. Whatever side you're starting with, you are going to squat and slam it as you come down. And you are slamming it like you freaking mean it so you can keep your heart rate up, all right? And then you'll just squat to the other side and then we'll repeat. Okay, here we go. 5 seconds. Put that towel on your right hand, get yourself ready. 3, 2, let's go. Slam it for 20 seconds. Make all the noise in the world. Let's go. Slam it down. Now you are squatting and not just leaning again. 3, 2, 1. Walk. Come on. Bend those legs. Water down. Lay on it. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch hands. You have 10 seconds if you need a drink. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. Squat. Slam it. Good. Woo! It feels so good when it makes that beautiful pop, doesn't it? We need that perfect hit on the ground. Yes. Come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 10 seconds. Other side. Make sure you are squatting. It's easy to fatigue. You just want to lean forward. All right, here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Final one. Come on. Squat. Slam it down. Let's go. Maybe squat first and then slam. Whatever feels right for you. Come on. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Song is my jam. All right, meet me down on the floor. Your final movement in this section are straight leg sit-ups, and we're gonna slam again. I'm going to fold my towel up and make it a little bit more of an aggressive hit. What we're doing, the towel's gonna start in your right hand for your 20 seconds. You are fully laid out. This hand is on your belly, on your chest, on your leg, but it's not helping you come up. It is not touching the floor, okay? You are going to rise up with your leg straight, and you're slamming on the outside of the opposite foot. And then roll yourself back down and come right back up into that slam, okay? 20 seconds with that hand, and then we just switch, all right? So this one's like nice and easy. It's like you're lying down on the ground. All right, right hand, lay back, in 4, 3, 2, 1. New leg, stay straight. You slam that towel up and back. Come on, it's a quick movement. You should not be a slow moving freight train. Let's go. Down and up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10 seconds. Switch hands. Switch hands. In 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's go. Slam it out. Come on. Down and up. Come on. Let's go. Bring it up. Get some energy and slam that towel down. Let's go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! All right. Final one. Total 40 seconds. 40 seconds left. Here we go. 4, 3, 2. Let's go. Sit up. Slam it out. Come on. If you know that you're towel slams have been pretty weak, dig it in here. Come on. This is that time when you can get rid of that aggression, that anger, whatever is bottled up inside you. Get rid of it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 10 seconds. Other side. 20 seconds of slams. Last chance to be all mad and angry. I'm giving you permission. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Sit it up. Slam it out. Come on. All the way up. Hit that ground. Up by your foot. Woo! Down and back. Come on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Break. The end is near. All right. We have 4 ab movements. They are 30 seconds each, 2 minutes. And then we finish with our little weights. and then you are done, okay? So all that is 30 seconds in a high plank, which we just drop right into 30 seconds of a low plank, and then we roll over onto our backs. We're alternating V up and then into a suitcase sit-up. So what that will look like, we start high plank, we'll drop into a low plank, we roll over to alternating V ups, which means opposite hand to opposite foot, and then a suitcase sit-up, or when your knees come in and your arms go out, and then you go back like you're folding up a suitcase, okay? 30 seconds of each, and then we have little arms. All right, go. High plank, get it up there. Do not sag, do not arch. Get in there, pull that belly button up into your spine. Your hands are directly underneath your shoulders. Come on, get relaxed, but pull that core in. Woo, 8 seconds. Come on, come on, come on, I'm with you. In 3, in 2, in 1, down to those elbows. That doesn't give you permission to sag in the middle or lift your butt up. Come on, pull that belly button to your spine. You're already halfway. And then you get to roll over onto your back. Come on, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, yes you can. 6, 5, pull it in. 4, 3, 2, 1, roll it over. Right into those alternating feet ups or toe touches. Come on. Opposite hand to opposite foot. Let's go. I know. Your abs are sore. I get it. But push through. Come on. It will not kill you. It will make you stronger. Let's go. Come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Final 30. You bring it all the way up. You reach those arms out and the heels come in. Back and up. You want to tuck your body, a little meatball at the top, right? Hold in, little tightness. Come on. Woo! You're halfway. We have 12 seconds. Extend, pull it in, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. You did it. You got through it. Good job. Water, towel off if you need to. Grab 2 or 3 pound weights. About 40 seconds. All right. All you do here is mirror me. Okay? There's going to be a song on. I don't know how well the acoustics or how well the audio sounds, but just keep your eyes on me. Follow all my movements and you will be golden. 20 seconds. Okay? So you have little weights. Maybe you're holding canned goods, bags of flour, whatever you got. 10 seconds. Oh man, this hour's flying by. I could do this all night with you. Here we go. All right, one weight in each hand. My members know this is my favorite song. Comfortably stand, roll your shoulders back and away. Core is pulled in, they're nice and tight. We're gonna curl up one at a time. Tight grip on, you're flexing, squeezing. Good, 4, 3, 2, we're gonna double it. Up, good, up, down, squeeze it. Keep those arms tucked in tight, up and down, good. 8, 7, 6, if you don't have weights, totally fine. 3, 2, 1, push those elbows out, we're gonna extend. Your hands are not resting on your chest. Good. Out and in. Again, you don't need weights, you can move your hands with me. Come on, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, double it, out, in. breathing. Keep your elbows lifted. Let's go. We have 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it here. Cross, cross. Good. You can do it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it. We lift and lower. Lift. Lower. 4, 3, 2, 1. Just switch. Up, lower. Good. Don't lean back. Kind of lean forward and tuck. In 4, 3, 2, 1. We're going to pull, cross, pull. So push all the way out, pull back. Good. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. You're here, one at a time. Under, back up. Under, up. Good. We have 7, under, 6, 5. Come on, stay with me. You can. 3, under, 2, under. We're gonna double it. So flip it up for 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So your hands are down, but they are not resting on your side. We're gonna push out one at a time. Out, out. Good. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Double it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold them here. We're so close. Do not drop those arms. Come on. Hold them out. Hold them out. We're gonna curl it in. 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 Good. 8, 7. Squeeze that core. Come on. We have 4, 3, 2, 1. Doubles. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give me 10 more seconds. Open those arms up and extend them out. Circles forward. Good. Reverse it. For 4, 3, 2, 1. And you're done. Good job. Put those weights down. Whew, lengthen your breath. We're going to cool it down together. So meet me on the floor. Come on down. Just have a seat. Sit with your legs out in front. And I just want you to fold forward and reach for those heels. Now, when you are in this position, I don't want you to just kind of like arch your body forward and fall forward. Sit up tall, taking a deep breath in and roll on top of your hips. And then bring your arms forward and around so you lose that hunchback and your spine is nice and long. You can grab a hold of your knees, your calves, your ankles, your shoelaces, whatever it is. Just try to press your elbows down into the floor. And again, lengthen those breaths that you're taking. So a deep breath in and a nice deep exhale. And as you exhale, kind of push your body a little bit farther. I completely forgot to give my little intermission speech, so my apologies. But thank you for those of you who did virtually tip me, which I think is really cool. Thank you to King of Prussia District. You're gonna cross one leg over and just hug it to your chest for inviting me to teach this Move Monday. I think it's really amazing, like I said in the beginning, supporting small businesses, especially right now. There's so much unknown. And a lot of us have worked really hard to just lose it right now. On their website, Switch Out Your Legs, or on their blog for visit, KOP.com. They also listed like 30 restaurants that are doing delivery and takeout. It's a really good time to support your community. And you can also donate to the Upper Marion Cupboard. And bring that foot in, tuck it. Just kind of drop to the front on your elbows if you can. Nice job. So every Monday there's a different gym. Reach for your heel if you can. A different fitness trainer or company that's going to be offering these classes. And
even though in the real world, we are all competitors. And right now, it's really important for all of us to be supporting each other. So make sure you check out. Switch out your legs. Next week's Move Monday. And then feel free to reach out to me and get more information about Dub Fitness and what it is that we do here. Bring your legs into a comfortable crisscross applesauce position. You're going to drop your arm down to the ground. I want you to reach up and over. Just close your eyes. You give me your armor. Just slowly switch over. You can have my heart. Just roll your arms forward, keeping your legs crossed. Drop your elbows down. Just focus. Take a deep breath in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. And slowly roll up. We're going to take a deep inhale together, staying seated. So let's inhale our arms up. And then exhale. Great job, everybody. It was amazing to be able to teach this class for you. Again, visit KOP.com, support local businesses, and Dub Fitness if you want to look me up. Great work. Stretch, eat some protein, hydrate, and enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you all so much.